brought to you by GTA. We start with you.
Delegate Mike Sinikelis with a not-so-veiled attack on decolonization posted from Washington, D.C. at 1 in the morning. In the post, Sinikelis compares Guam's decolonization movement to adulting, saying the surest way to be an adult is to go out there and be one and ignore the labels, ignore the shortcomings, ignore the challenges. Sinikelis alluding that Guam should go out there and adult and get a job, get a car, get a house. He wraps up the FB post by saying all of these things are, quote, adulting, and the same goes for decolonization. Decolonization Statehood Task Force Chair Eloy Hara sharing his thoughts on Sinikelis' FB post after hearing it for the first time this morning.
He said a lot of nothing. Congressman Sinikelis, I'm personally addressing you, that you need to get off your butt, get out in public and do your job. That's what you're elected to do. And take it from me, you might be definitely a one-time, one-term congressman if you continue the way you act now, very childish.
Both Hara and Independence Task Force Chair Dr. Mike Bavacqua pointing out the irony that Guam's political status has kept the island from adulting at a level the congressman would be comfortable with. Bavacqua found flaws in how Sinikelis has said nothing has been accomplished with decolonization.
He mentioned Commission on Self-Determination, OPIR, successive generations of leaders, and nothing has been done on this issue. And for me, I just don't understand that, because it's like, no. People have done lots of things. People have tried lots of things. And I'm confused because, you know, I know that his grandfather served on the Commission on Self-Determination for a long time. And it's a strange argument, because what he's saying there basically makes it seem like no one before him has adulted.
While the two men represent opposite ends of the political status spectrum, they both agreed that Delegate Sinikelis doesn't have the best grasp of Guam's political history. Both men citing Guam building its tourism economy post-war, the almost two-decade-long push for Commonwealth that was eventually rejected by Congress, and the walkout that forced the federal government's hand.
Is he saying that no one before him has ever done anything? Well, because if he has, then that's a strange position to take.
That's why, in plain language, I commented that he said a lot of nothing, including the walkout. You know, when we walked out, and that's how we got the Organic Act of Guam.
Childish temper tantrum, then walkout.
But at least we got, you know, at least a little bit better position than...
He simplified it down in such a way which doesn't make sense. It's the language that the colonizer uses. They say that you're a child.
Yeah.
You have to grow up. Once you grow up, then you can have nice things.
Was the post a distraction? The congressman talking about adulting while facing allegations of adultery and campaign finance abuse. Hara, meanwhile, compared the decolonization work of Sinikelis' grandfather, the late senator and former Speaker Franklin Kitigwa, to his grandson's apparent disdain for the decolonization process.
I respect your grandfather, but I've lost respect for you, and you holding the highest position that Etsomoru from Guam could hold, but your grandfather would be very embarrassed of you right now.
The group chat episode posted on our KUAM News Facebook page.
Brought to you by GTA. We start with you.